अब इट्स माई ड्यूटी दैट एंड फर्दर योर्स एज वेल दैट टू स्ट्रेच इट यू नो टू एंश्योर दैट योर नेम विल बी अपियर्ड इन द लिस्ट विद दिस ऑप्शनल इटसेल्फ। हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू प्लूटस आईएएस एंड मायसेल्फ अक्षय गुरु भैया, फैकल्टी ज्योग्राफी ऑप्शनल। So guys, I am here with one interesting session for you, that is on geography optional. What exactly it is, what how you are supposed to approach this particular subject, what are the different sources for this matter to refer for, then what common mistakes you guys, you know, or the those who are aspirants for the UPSC examination usually commits, right, while preparing for this optional, and in addition what your common concerns, because I have been teaching this particular subject since 7 to 8 years now, and I have, you know, faced lots of doubts and concerns of the aspirants about this particular subject. So it's it's my for this video the strategy is just to answer all of your concern, all of your queries, and at the end of this session what I would like to ensure that you guys should have, you know, firm and pretty much clear decision of yours that you are going to opt the geography as optional. So now, without wasting further time, I shall start this video and watch it till the end, because this video will solve all your doubts and concerns. So guys, see, the very first, I welcome you all to unfolding the journey of geography optional preparation. See, this very first slide, it's about what exactly geography it means, because you know why the very slide has been added. मतलब नॉर्मली आपको डेफिनेशन बताकर भी आई कैन यू नो आई कुड हैव प्रोसीड फर्दर, बट द थिंग इज आई फील द नीड दैट आई शैल एक्सप्लेन द मीनिंग ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट इन यू नो दैट मच डिटेल, सो यू गाइज विल हैव ए प्रीटी मच क्लैरिटी ओवर द सिलेबस एक्सपैंड एंड द डेप्थ ऑफ दिस सब्जेक्ट डोमेन एज वेल. So, you know, what usually we are having in mind, that geography optional is all dealing with the mountains, rocks, plateaus, rivers, and those non-living phenomena. But believe me guys, that is not a true geography is all about. Geography is such a diverse field of social science that actually finds an integration between science and social science. So this particular subject is really an interesting area, so that you know you can understand all about your surrounding. The reason being, see, first pehle definition dekhte hain, then I'll help you to connect with the subject, that what is geography. The geography is simply the term, if you ask like the very root meaning of this term, then see, this term is having meaning. Geo, it means the earth, and graphene, it means to study, or more appropriately to write or to study. So it is simply like the subject that deals with the study of the earth. But one thing I would like to add over here, see, it's not about earth, is not all about the non-living aspect. What we usually or like tends to consider, that earth is all about non-living aspect, rocks, interior of the earth, then atmospheric phenomena, climate, then oceans and all these things. See, ये तो एक indiscriminate part of the geography is. However, the real geography is equally lies in the life that sustains on the part of the earth. That the earth is incomplete, because the core domain of the geography is the earth, and the core domain of the earth, okay, is simply the non-living existence on this part, non-living existence on this part, and equally the living existence on the surface as well. Just say you will find oceans over here, you will find rocks over here, you will find atmosphere that is lying up in the surface. Then simultaneously you will find this living matters, vegetation. Equally you will find human population, flora and fauna, that makes this earth a complete entity. You cannot imagine earth without having or considering the existence of life on this. So what I have explained this fact, the reason is simple, that usually we consider a geography is all about non-living aspect, but believe me, this is not a geography. And when you enter into this particular optional domain, believe me, you will find lots of interest when you will be dealing with this living entities as a whole. Industrial geography, historical geography, political geography, then economic geography, these are all, you know, dealing with the living aspect as a whole. So like the Eratosthenes, he was the very first man who had drawn the map, okay, of the earth's surface. And that's why, and further his contribution considering, he is known as the father of geography. And like the definition, if you want to consider, then geography is the study of lands, the non-living aspect, features over on the land like mountain, plateau, plains, rivers, then rock surface, interior of the earth, and how phenomena varies. Inhabitant, you cannot neglect the earth, you cannot study the earth without its inhabitant. So flora and fauna both, and their related phenomena mean their interrelations and how each of this phenomena then affects them as well, right? This is what the area of this optional study. It is usually this means of the earth and its natural processes, natural events and people that it includes them, you know. So I hope now you guys are having a broader definition of the geography, jahan par hum, we will broaden the definition to include the living entities over in the subject domain as well. Okay, so do ensure this fact, geography is a very broad domain and considerations as okay. Then this subject matter, because like say you should have the pretty much clarity about, you know, so it's my duty first that I shall explain you the basics of geography in the this explanation itself. There are various branches of geography. Now these branches you will find even in the NCERT 11th geography first chapter itself. Okay, wahan par ye clearly mentioned hai. So what you will find, there are like physical geography branch, physical geography that deals with the physical non-living aspects of the earth surface, and jahan pe aapka geography se introduction bhi hota hai na, in those school days as well, you and me were introduced with this domain of geographical knowledge. So that is physical. It is subdivided further into astronomical geography, geomorphology, climatology, oceanography, then environmental geography and biogeography, right? Soil geography as well. So actually soil geography forms a part of biogeography itself. So this domains are sub areas of this physical geographical studies. And human geography that ensures the human element, living element with the geographical connect. So you will find it is further divided like population geography or demographic geography as well, anthropo geography, human evolution, political geography, geopolitics jisko hum kehte hai, so that geopolitical geography, social geography, tribal and their culture and cultural geography, economic geography divided into agriculture, trade, transport and industries, and then historical geography and settlement geography. Yeah, they say last year you will find in 2023 itself there was a question in the GS1 that how geographical factors are behind the development of ancient India. Yeah, see, this question simply belongs to the historical geography, that how, you know, the geographical developments are, you know, like in the past, how they were in the past. So that way. And now the new evolving branch, that is regional geography, which macro region, meso region and micro region, it actually includes. Though it is a, you know, like newly evolving branch, but yeah, absolutely it is equally a important part of the geographical studies. So this part, it helps you to have a broader idea about the subject. Then the most important point of this video, the most important point of this overall discussion, the most important point why you guys are supposed to study optional. See, many students, they just like, you know, they just have the this tendency it just because that is given in our subject, it is given in our syllabus, so what we need to study that particular subject. But believe me guys, see, you have to do it just because you have opted for this particular examination. But see, being a rational human being, or being, you know, the analytical individual, it's your duty that you should look for why this subject forms a part of our syllabus. देखो, UPSC ने कोई syllabus या कोई subject ऐसे randomly cheat box से cheats निकाल के रखा नहीं है, है ना? Every subject finds a reason behind its inclusion in the syllabus. So the thing is, why geography is part of our syllabus? It just because why it forms a part of our syllabus, because the geography will help you in the future that how to make your duties more aligned with, you know, the constitution of India, how to make your duties, how to make your every work done to be more aligned with the betterment of the society, how again to ensure the welfare states, because you are, you know, the representative of the parts of the welfare state when you will be selected as in. So in such a case, what you need to ensure that why it is a parts of syllabus, because when you will be posted in a tribal area, aapko pata hona chahiye ki tribes ke culture kya hota hai. Cultural geography will help there. When you will be posted in Jammu and Kashmir, you must know about what is the topography of the region and why terrorism is, you know, the kind of a prominent over there. When you will be posted over in the Odisha, you should know about why cyclone, what exactly the cyclone is and how, you know, it leads to the significant damage that we can see over in the region and how to mitigate that disaster. So believe me, when you guys will be doing with this particular subject and that domain, you will be having pretty much clarity when you will be serving, you know, as an district collector, as an, you know, any kind of officer over in your area then. So this optional, I believe, is not only for the purpose ki aapko marks dene. This optional is what, like, rather something that will change your overall perspective about your surrounding, about your region itself. So see, I hope now you guys are having pretty much clarity. Ispe hum aur bhi in detail discussions hoga when you will be sitting in my class, right? In Plutus, we ensure this thing ki har kisi topic pe, har kisi areas pe, we shall have a enough discussion so that, you know, you guys will be having pretty much clarity and that could be reflected over in your answer writing as well. Okay, so next, that now this is what we have seen, the importance in the importance of this optional further in your life and even during the course of preparation. But does it have any relevance over in the UPSC examination perspective? Answer is absolutely yes, absolutely. In each of the stages of the examination, like for that matter prelims, for that matter interview, mains, writing stage and interview, personality test, you will find for all these stages, geography will help you to, you know, score better, to have your understanding better, and ultimately improve the rank that you are actually seeking for. So preliminary mein agar dekhoge, so in 2023, questions were of the order like almost 15 to 17 questions. Yeah, in 2024 as well, questions were of the order 17 to 18, and if you add environment into it, so questions were almost of the order 30 questions, as in 30 questions. And same, this particular chart will further explains you the nature, okay, or the weightage that is given by the UPSC to this optional itself. That means at least for the prelims, this topic is unavoidable. When the examination is all about 200 marks, or jaise 24 ka agar hum case le, 30 questions, it means 60 marks you are, you know, scoring from the this subject, based on this subject, absolutely you are not supposed to neglect it. Yeah, agar ise neglect kar doge to you will find your result is you won't find your name in the result. So you cannot neglect this subject over in the prelims. Yeah, now what is the case then for the mains? Answer is, you know, that this subject is equally right, it cannot be, you know, avoided. Like, in a sense, while writing for in the mains examination, you will find its relevance over in the paper of essay. 8 topics are there, and believe me guys, 8 topics, koi bhi topic le lo, aapko geography ka knowledge wahan pe chahiye hi rahega. Yeah, you know, you cannot be multi-dimensional, yeah, multi-perspective in, like, in the absence of having a geographical knowledge and understanding perspective. So out of this 8, at least maybe one topic is directly concerning with the geography itself, climate change, global warming, the environmental initiatives, weather, and even for the rest of the topics you will find geography connects it well with. Okay, so SMA, yes, GS1, like last year you will find 10 questions almost out of 20 questions in GS1 were of geography. So almost 8 to 9 questions to for sure hota hai of the geography, that almost leads to 10 questions, it means 250 say 125 marks in the paper 1 itself you will be scoring based on this subject matter and its, you know, knowledge. Then in paper 3, yahan par to you will find agriculture is equally part of, though it finds connect with the economics as well. Then equally environment and ecology is there. Yeah. And then equally you will find disaster management. You know, disaster management. Environment, ecology, 4 questions, disaster management 2 questions, agriculture 2 or 3 questions. This all questions will be answered effectively based on the knowledge expertise that you guys will be getting from the geography optional itself. So again, almost for more than 100 marks, you will find it has its relevance. So, dekho, you will find GS1 mein 100 marks over in the GS3 and SA, and at the end 500 marks over in. So this paper is, I believe, is not merely of 500 marks. Believe me, if you prepare geography optional, you are not preparing for 500 marks, you are rather preparing for almost around 800 marks. Almost around 800 marks. And I'm not considering the personality test questions over there. Because when you will be, you know, sitting over on the chair, you will be asked about the climate change, you will be asked about Delhi's air pollution, you will be asked about your area and its regional geography, maybe its surrounding, maybe the problem, agricultural problems over in the country, inflation jo tomato ke prices se ho raha hai, jo potato ke prices se ho raha hai, and just like onion ke prices se ho raha hai. So you will find you will be in a better position to answer those questions with the knowledge of this subject domain. So see guys, when you consider to take geography as a optional, you should not consider ki ye aap sirf 500 marks ke liye prepare kar rahe ho. You are rather preparing it for almost 800 plus marks. 800 plus marks, you know, that is really a huge contribution of the subject then. Huge contribution. I feel aur koi subject itna zyada contribution nahi karta hoga over in the preparation of this UPSC as a whole. Theek hai? So yeah, this is what the significance of this optional. Now then the question remains. Now I have cleared the clouds of doubt over on the wide forms a part of syllabus. Then again, the whether it really connects with the UPSC examination as well. Answer is yes. Now then the question remains, then how to study this subject? See, because like now I have been teaching this subject since a long, so I feel ki what usually the kinds of mistakes say, or the, you know, that what usually the problem that occurs with while understanding with the geography optional, and what I have seen, you know, that while preparing for the geography optional, let's say I'm common mistakes bhi dekhenge at the end of this video itself, but yahan pe how to study geography I'm what trying to answer you. See, geography is very logical and conceptual subject. है ना. सो इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड, ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस सब्जेक्ट बाय मीन्स ऑफ इट्स लॉजिक एंड वेरी डीप कंसेप्ट, वेरी कंसेप्ट ऑफ इट, बिलीव मी यू विल फाइंड लॉट्स ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इन दिस सब्जेक्ट. एटलीस्ट यू आर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो टिल दिस एंड, इट मीन्स यू आर हैविंग यू नो दैट कनेक्ट विद द सब्जेक्ट. अब इट्स माय ड्यूटी दैट एंड फर्दर योर्स एज वेल दैट टू स्ट्रेच इट यू नो टू एंश्योर दैट योर नेम विल बी अपीयर्ड इन द लिस्ट विद दिस ऑप्शनल इटसेल्फ. सो एट द प्लूटस आईज वी विल एंश्योर दिस फैक्ट और वी हैव बीन एंश्योरिंग दिस फैक्ट कि जो भी सब्जेक्ट है पर्टिकुलरली लाइक से एज नाउ इन द केस ज्योग्राफी दैट इससे रिलेटेड आंसर राइटिंग दिस रेगुलर यू नो द मगिंग अप ऑफ द सिलेबस रेगुलर पी वाई क्यूज डिस्कशन विल बी हेल्ड इन आर classes. Okay, so and that will help you to have a better conceptual clarity by just like in the classes you will find by means of videos, by means of visualization practice, by means of different things, right, by means of flow charts. I'll try my best ki aapko ye concept sare class mein hi clear ho jaye. Then next, geography is in our surrounding. This is what I am firm believer of, that you guys should not look this matter, you know, this geography as merely the subject that helps you to gain, you know, post or like a knowledge. But believe me, it is something that is that lies in your surrounding, in a sense that the soil on which you are having the food that is produced, the climate over in your surrounding, monsoon and rainfall, that you know that how this rains and winds that finally leads to rainfall, then equally the temperature condition, then the presence of various topographies, the presence of different minerals, iron, steel and all other features, you know, they are all lying in our surrounding. Don't try to look this subject matter merely in the books, because if you ask merely the book, you will find itna hi milega jitna wo books de sakta hai. When you are like with open eyed, you know, you are like observant enough, you will find you are getting more than what is actually expected. So it is in our surrounding, and do ensure this thing ki wo aapko waise hoga bhi. Imagining and interlinking of the different geographical phenomena, how geography of monsoon is connected with the geography of agriculture, how monsoon is connected with the human migration, how monsoon is connected with the human health system, how cyclone impacts on the overall soil salinization. So you need to connect overall aspect, how the disaster management helpful for the industry establishment. तो जितना ज्यादा कनेक्ट करोगे गाइज उतना यू विल फाइंड दैट दिस इज गिविंग यू रिटर्न प्रोपोर्शनेटली. ओके, देन लाइक हैव सम एनिमेटिक एनिमेशन एंड दोज रिप्रेजेंटेशन, सो दैट यू विल फाइंड कि और भी जो क्लैरिटी है वो ज्यादा होगी. जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल, बिकॉज लाइक यू नेवर हैव सीन हाउ अर्थ रोटेट्स, है ना, वो तो आपने वीडियो में देखा है तब आपको समझ आया. हाउ सोलार सिस्टम एक्चुअली ऑपरेट्स यू हैव नेवर सीन इन रियलिटी, दैट इज मेयरली बाय मीन्स ऑफ विजुअलाइजेशन और एनिमेटिक प्रेजेंटेशन. सो डू एंश्योर एनिमेशंस या यूट्यूब पे वीडियोज है, यू आर वॉचिंग देम ऑन रेगुलर बेसिस वेन एवर यू फाइंड एटलीस्ट डाउट एंड डिफिकल्टी इन विजुअलाइजेशन. रिविजन इज द की, revision is the key, because see, in the absence of revision it is very difficult to ensure and remember all those facts. Then solving the questions, PYQs and repetitive test series. At Plutus IES we offers you the deep analysis of the PYQs and on regular basis, and equally the टेस्ट सीरीज as well, है ना. टेस्ट सीरीज रेगुलर होती है आपके, इनफैक्ट आपके सेशंस में, बैचेस में आपके ऑलमोस्ट 35 टेस्ट विल बी एंश्योर्ड, है ना, दोज विल बी एंगेज. एंड अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस यू विल बी गेटिंग 12 टेस्ट, फुल टेस्ट, फुल लेंथ टेस्ट सीरीज as well. सो यू विल बी बेनिफिटेड बाय ऑल दिस एफर्ट्स. सी, वी आर नॉट लुकिंग फॉर मेयरली एडमिशन, वी आर लुकिंग फॉर द अल्टीमेट रिजल्ट ऑफ yours as well. So, see, now the three pillars of our optional preparation, because now, अब जब आप ये वीडियो यहाँ तक देख रहे हैं, it means now you are a bit convinced about, yes, कि prepare तो करेंगे हम, okay? Then, what are the three pillars of? You should have a right study material, you should have, you know, your own prepared notes on every topic and subtopic of the syllabus. You should have a comprehensive notes, and then PYQs and test series. That is our duty from our side, that will be, we will be ensuring this thing. Then the most common question again, Okay, sir, what are the sources then to be referred? Sources are pretty much common, you know, that you will find even on the other sources. And I feel, see guys, sources are much important, no doubt. But because har koi same source pad raha hai, so source is not, you know, that case. Rather, how you get the content and how you present that content, that what matters over here. So sources on that matter, the basic, I have divided into like this basic sources and reference sources. Then reference sources paper wise we will try to address them. See, you can have a screenshot of this so that aapke paas sources bhi rahenge. Basic books, NCRTs 11th and 12th expected. Agar 6 se padh lo to aur bhi zyada clarity aayegi, so that will again help you. Then Rupa publication, Rup made simple notes, na? So those are basically two titles, you will find on, so volume 1 and volume 2 you guys are supposed to go through, so that you will be having a better idea again about the subject domain. And GC Leong, that is a certificate course in geography, that is a book, and that explains more about the geographical concepts and clarity. Okay, so these are the basic books. Those are ultimately they are unavoidable for the case of this preparation. But equally, now you have to follow some reference books. अब ये reference books है paper wise, जैसे for example for paper 1 physical geography and paper 2 you will find, sorry, paper 1 human geography, you need to follow some titles like physical geography by Savindra Singh, like, and you only supposed to refer this one and some part of this title geomorphology. जैसे यहाँ से आप देखोगे slope development वाला topic होगा या geomorphology applications होगा. Oceanography से you will find यहाँ से ocean related aspects कुछ ही area cover करने हैं. और climatology by Savindra Singh sir, or climatology by Lal and Lal, so any one book you guys can refer. Environmental geography by Savindra Singh, you can even skip this title if you find it suitable and time allows, tab bhi dekhna hai. Biogeography refers Rupa made simple, that you have already gone through, see by the time you will reach over here. So already paper 2 human geography, now you need to refer multiple titles over here, right? Ab perspective is in human geography us book ke liye ya us topic ke liye. We have geographical thoughts by the Majid Hussain sir, we have geographical thought by the R.D. Dixit sir, yeah, and chapter as well, those are being mentioned. Or you can even the Sudipta Adhikari their book, his book basically is geographical thought by the Sudipta Adhikari, and chapter you guys can refer to. So this book you at least supposed to refer any two among this two, sorry, three, you at least supposed to refer any two books as in, right, to have a better clarity. Then Human Geography by Majid Hussain sir and Models and Theories by Majid Hussain sir. Again, these titles help you to have pretty much clarity over in the Human Geography section. Aur yahan pe Rupa Made Simple wali jo book hai, Rupa Made Simple, that volume 2, that will again for the purpose of economic geography itself. Okay, so these are what the book list for the paper 1. Paper 2 ke liye kya hai? See, paper 2 ke liye hamare paas ek bible hai, yeah, right, that is what the India, a comprehensive geography, DR Khullar sir, that is usually considered as like a bible of the Indian geography, jahan se aapko cover kar sakte ho, given in, though bulky hai, but given in very lucid, easy, and again full of map, full of diagram, full of charts and data as well. So your argument will be much stronger while when you will be writing answers. Or you can else as well refers to the Indian Geography by Majid Hussain sir, so wo bhi refer kar sakte ho. Apart from this, Student Atlas jo aapko latest edition ye recommend ye bhi karna hai, ye Blackstone wala bhi kar sakte ho, anyway you find suitable. India Year Book, yeah, that though you can skip this India Year book as well, current affairs agar regular read kar rahe ho, so that is fair enough. Economic Survey, much needed for the purpose of data, facts and some observation schemes as well. Then Yojana Magazine, Kurukshetra Magazine for rural geography, settlements and again new initiatives. Down to Earth Magazine dealing with the geography, agar skip kar sakte ho agar if you are going through newspaper on daily basis. And this Kurukshetra Magazine, the Hindu newspaper is pretty much needed, so that at the end you will find ki is topics pe, kyunki dekho paper 2 it seems like more of a general paper. The reason being, because इस पे questions ऐसे होते हैं कि GS जैसे और optional में same लगे, but you are not supposed to write the same answer as you would have rather written over in the paper GS, right? So you have to have some difference over in the paper 2. इस पे class में discuss करते हैं हम generally answer writing के वक्त कि paper 2 के answers how they are different from the paper GS paper 1, GS paper 2 and any other paper of the GS, right? So that is what, you know, the crucial aspect that you guys should understand. Then, what are the common mistakes that I have seen? This, you know, see, geography is such a subject that it can help you to score even beyond 300. 300, and there are many examples. If you have seen, there are many examples, lots of examples. But see, why many candidates fail to achieve that 300 plus wala score? The reason being, there are some, you know, some common mistakes those are being committed by them. See what exactly? See, like NCERTs are so basic. I was literally shocked when I heard about, like, I heard, and sir, NCERTs, are we really supposed to follow NCERT? Because they are so basic books. They are so basic. Believe me, guys, but this basic leads to your foundation. You are not supposed to skip the NCERT. Is the reason being those, you know, agar koi building banani hai to uska foundation strong hona chahiye. And foundations is actually built up by this NCERT. So don't consider NCERTs as so basic. They are rather the very foundational books. Then rush to, they are, you guys are, or many students are having, you know, rush to reference, rush to the reference book. Care itni mehengi book liye, itni bulky book liye, to what I need to go through this book? No. First, have clarity with the NCERT, have good relations with the NCERT, and then go through the reference books, those bulky books. Ki padhne to hai, no doubt, but not all, right? Keep your sources limited and ensure you will have your result. Because if you are going to read multiple sources, hai na? Like multiple reference material or sources, if you are going to, believe me, that is not going to work. The reason being, ek hi source hai, usme climatology ki, ya monsoon ki concept alag alag na di hogi. Wohi hoga, 80% concept to same hogi. Only for the sake of 20%, you are wasting, you know, your time and equally efforts. And that is absolutely not advisable when the examination is 1 year long draining process. Okay. Then neglect, usually you'll find, sorry, quantity over like quality, and that is what you are never supposed to do. Always ensure that quality and quantity should have a symbiotic relationship, that you should have a right mixture of quantity as well as quality. While case of preparation, quality matlab content, and quantity it means the number of books or other that you are trying for. Then multiple reference material already. Then neglect, usually common mistake is student or aspirant tends to neglect PYQs. And believe me, in our class, har kisi student ko syllabus or PYQ, syllabus to tip of tongue hota hai, always 20 units are there, and almost all students, you know, in my class, they are like, I'll ensure ki ko 20 units of syllabus yaad hi ho. Yes, just within initial 10-15 days, sari kuch cheeze yaad hoti hai, and PYQs equally. But that before discussing any topic, I'll ensure, right? I ensure this fact ki PYQs us topics pe kaun se aaye. So that one, you are as well supposed to ensure this thing. We'll write answer afterwards, yeah? Because I am not well prepared for this matter, or I can do it even afterwards as well. Ye bhi nahi karna hai, and evaluation is less important. Never. See, evaluation is very important. The reason being, if you are committing a same mistake and again, right? Einstein has said, insanity is doing the same thing again and again and expecting a different result. No, because if you are committing a same mistake in answer writing, now that has become your habit. Ab habit aise ban gayi hai, that is what a mistake. Ab evaluator, if he's really ready for, he won't be giving you enough marks. So do ensure evaluation is much needed for this examination. Okay, so you have to ensure this fact. And at the last now, ek aur concern jo aapka rehta hai na, at least now with this discussion, you must be much convinced about, pretty much convinced about, yes, geography is worth enough to have like as an optional. I strongly believe this fact, right? I strongly believe this thing that you are now much convinced. But phir bhi ek aur doubt aayega, aapke friends aayenge aapke paas, aapke known and near and dear ones aayenge, koi aur already koi individual ne agar ye clear kiya exam ya appear kiya, to he must be like ke geography mein sach mein geography ke result hai bhi ya nahi hai, or like that of concern. So this is, you know, the last and very important concern that you should have, you know, ultimately evaporate after this particular explanation. That, see, there are number of optional in the UPSC preparation, and geography at first is one of the highest taken optional. Theek hai, sabse zyada optional agar le rahe koi opt kar rahe, that is like geography is one of those subjects. And if you follow, right, I have added few subjects and there टेकर्स, दीज आर द नंबर ऑफ टेकर्स यूजुअली, ठीक है, गिवन बाय द यूपीएससी इटसेल्फ. 314 इज वॉट एट द एंड यू विल फाइंड द रिजल्ट, एंड 7.2 इज वॉट द एट द एंड द सक्सेस रेशो. मोर और लेस सारे पी एस आई आर इफ यू कंसिडर, एंथ्रोपोलॉजी, सोशोलॉजी, हिस्ट्री इफ यू कंसिडर, सक्सेस रेट ओवर इन दिस ऑप्शनल इज होवरिंग अराउंड 7-10%, राइट. हर साल चेंज होगा दो दिस फिगर, बट बिलीव मी सक्सेस रेट ऑफ द ऑप्शनल ज्योग्राफी इज नॉट इज एट अ पार विद द अदर ऑप्शनल सब्जेक्ट एज वेल. सो नेवर यू नो गेट डीमोरलाइज, लाइक से सक्सेस रेट कम है. एंड अल्टीमेटली आई फील यू गाइज यू नो यू वॉन्ट ओनली वन सिंगल रिजल्ट, है ना, यू आर द ओनली वन सिंगल सीट. सो दैट डजेंट मैटर कि मतलब सक्सेस कितना भी हो रहा है, वैसे मैटर करता है, बट फिर भी यू वॉन्ट यू नीड टू बी अमॉन्ग दिस नंबर, राइट, दिस 314. यस, एक ही आपको वो इंश्योर करना है, द रेस्ट इज नॉट यूर कॉज ऑफ कंसर्न. सो ऑन द स्केल ऑफ इवन सक्सेस रेट, ज्योग्राफी इज इवन क्वालिफाइंग. सो आई फील दैट दिस whole video that explains you about the significance of this geography optional, what exactly subject is about, why it forms a part of syllabus, then the weightage given in the prelims, means an interview as well, then sources to be referred, then your common concerns and common mistakes. Yeah, I feel at this point of this your journey, now you are convinced about this thing. If you still have any doubt, so just feel free to comment in the comment box. I'll make sure ki aapke wo sare doubts hum answer kar de, or else you can visit to our location as well over in the New Delhi, hai na, or you can approach, you know, over on the call as well. So I would like to answer all your queries. I feel very happy कि मैं अगर आपके डाउट्स फर्दर ज्योग्राफी से रिलेटेड रिजॉल्व कर सकता हूँ तो. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट फॉर टुडे फॉर दिस वीडियो. आई रियली वेलकम यू टू दिस जर्नी ऑफ ज्योग्राफी ऑप्शनल, विच इज रियली, बिलीव मी, विच इज रियली लॉजिकल एंड ए विजुअलाइज्ड, ओके, और द जर्नी ऑफ विजुअलाइजेशन इटसेल्फ. So I wish you all the best. If you have any query, don't forget to comment in the comment box or approach to our center as well. I'll try to answer all of them. I wish you all the best and thank you guys.